Good morning. Today we celebrate the most holy body and blood of Christ. We welcome all. We will celebrate the feast of Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, with a short procession around the church at the end of the 10 a.m. Mass this morning, closing the benediction. Festival volunteers are needed after the 10 a.m. Mass to help with cleanup and pack-up. Please meet in the parish hall. Vacation Bible School is only 2 weeks away. Send in your registration forms as soon as possible for the week of fun learning to let our light shine for Jesus. The week is for four-year-olds through adults. A special remembrance is made in this Mass for Helen Kramer. Please stand. Our opening hymn is number 567, God We Praise You, number 567.
Still. us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. We live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, as to test you by affliction, and to find out whether or not it is your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be affected with hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes from forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert, with its serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless land, who brought forth water to you from the flinty rock, and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our song response this morning is, "Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia."
Ancient types fulfilling, Isaac bound, a victim willing, past the land its floodlight spilling, manna to the Father sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesus, of your love, befriend us. You refresh us and defend us. Your eternal God, descend us in the land of life to see. You, who all things can and know, who on earth such food bestow, grant us with your saints through the lowest, where the heavenly feast you show. Fellow heirs and guests to thee, amen, alleluia.
Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think one of the greatest gifts that children can either teach us or remind us is the ability to be totally awed by something. The look on their faces when they come downstairs on a Christmas morning, or the first time they go on a ride on an amusement park, or when there's a great fireworks display, or they come in contact with a playful puppy, or even just trying to catch lightning bugs on a summer evening. But it seems like the older that we get, the fewer and fewer experiences fill us with that same kind of wonder and awe. What stops us from appreciating the same things with the same kind of enthusiasm that we once had? I think what happens sometimes is that we either get too focused or too distracted to appreciate what's in our presence. Just think about relationships, for example. Don't you see that happening there? You know, what about two people who are so much in love and seem to be inseparable? They may run into those same type of pitfalls, and they may take that relationship for granted. Or how about just in everyday situations when you run across a person maybe that you haven't seen for a while? Say maybe you've gone to a class reunion and you see somebody over there and you want to just be able to go up and reconnect and get reacquainted. But what happens sometimes is that the response you get is somebody that, oh yeah, and then they're kind of half listening to you. They're less than enthusiastic. And maybe they're looking around for maybe someone else to talk to or to cut this conversation short. Or even at times when we're used to something that's familiar, when we've gone to something once, it's like, oh, that was nice, that experience. And say something happens on an annual event. Maybe a neighbor of yours has an annual type of party. Oh, we're invited to that again. Well, I guess we're obliged to go. You know, maybe we can just go late. Maybe we can make an excuse for leaving early. But you know what happens? No one likes to be ignored, do they? No one likes to be forgotten. No one likes to be treated with insignificance. All of us want to be remembered. And so does Jesus. At the Last Supper, Jesus said, "This is my body. This is my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." He didn't do this because of his own need to be remembered. But we need to remember him. And we need to do it because of the graces that he can offer us and his love. And to remember this, Jesus has given us the greatest gift of all. It's what we celebrate in a particularly powerful way today. We celebrate Corpus Christi, the gift of his presence in the Eucharist. At the Last Supper, Jesus knew that he was going to die soon. And in his love, he wanted to leave us something. He wanted to be constantly present to his loved ones. He wanted us to have a way to know, to really know, and to really see feel that he is here among us. Now that's created some challenges for Jesus, right? The first challenge is that he had to leave us, yet he wanted to stay with us. So how do you solve that challenge? You listen to his words. "This is my body. This is my blood." The bread and wine look and feel and taste like bread and wine, but they are not. They mystically become the reality of the risen Christ, present among us for all ages. The second challenge was that Jesus came to save us, and he wanted to give his life, to die for us. And yet, he could only die once for us as a human being. So this is the great mystery of the Incarnation. God became flesh in the man of Jesus of Nazareth. He is truly God, but truly human. So how does Jesus solve this challenge? You go back again to his words. "Do this in remembrance of me." That same victim who was crucified once for us outside the walls of Jerusalem centuries ago returns again to this altar today and every day that we celebrate the Eucharist. And the third challenge he faced, he wanted to be one with us. And yet this would be impossible this side of heaven. So how does Jesus solve that challenge? Again, listen to his words. He says, "Take and eat. Take and drink." So Jesus now invites us to become one with himself in communion. These were the three ways in which Jesus solved the challenges he faced at the Last Supper. He had to leave us, and yet he wanted to stay and And so he left us and stays, and the bread and wine become the reality of the risen Christ. He wanted to die for us, and yet he could die, but once as a human being. And so the victim, the lamb that was sacrificed, returns again to the altar every time we celebrate this sacrificial meal. He wanted to be one with us, and yet he couldn't this side of heaven. So he gave us the next best thing. He gave us communion. If anything should maintain and increase our own awe and wonder, it is this miracle. It is the Eucharist that we will shortly receive. This feast of Corpus Christi we celebrate began in Belgium in 1247 from an Augustinian nun, Julian of Liège, who was favored with visions and ecstasies from God, who reminded her that there was no peace in honor of his presence in the most holy Eucharist. And because of these visions, she urged the archdeacon to approve such a feast in her diocese. And this archdeacon eventually became Pope Urban IV, who in 1264 extended this glorious solemnity to the entire universal church. That time, 1200 years after the institution of the Eucharist, people were neglecting the vital importance of this sacrament. Unfortunately, we can still see that lack of reverence and gratitude even today, even though Jesus is still and always present in this Holy Eucharist. The Eucharist is a spiritual bond that is forged between us and Jesus, between us and God Almighty. And it is his body and blood that will be coursing through our own body and blood. And we are in a more intimate relationship with Jesus Christ than if he were physically present to us today. We are not just in communication with him. We are in communion with him. Holy Communion. The Eucharist is Jesus. The Eucharist is God himself. The Eucharist is everything. What more could anyone want? What else could bring us closer to God? So don't ever disconnect yourself from Jesus. And when we are in line coming up to receive him, are we just feeling we're going through a routine? Are we totally distracted? Are we indifferent? Or are we prepared to receive Holy Communion with our Lord? Allow this feast today of Corpus Christi to rejuvenate that awe, that wonder in coming into the presence and intimate Holy Communion with Jesus Christ, our Lord. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God from God,
light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation,
he came down from heaven,
and by the Holy Spirit
was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake, he was crucified and
punished by Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven,
and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again
in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Jesus offered his body and blood as a sacrifice to bring eternal life. Trusting in his love, let us offer our prayers to the Father.
For the Church, Christ's body on earth, may God strengthen us to joyfully live our faith, bringing glory to our Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who hold political and more civic authority, may God guide them in protecting and providing for the weak, especially those who have no voice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For broken and wounded families, may the love of Christ bring healing and reconciliation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the Christian men and women to have courage and wisdom to stand up to defend our faith and moral values at these times of persecution, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may the Holy Spirit inspire us in every word and deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Rita Klein, Helen Kornopolesky, and Anthony Friendly, as they receive his body and blood in this life, may Jesus receive them into his heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, hear our prayers and answer them according to your divine will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 407 at the Lamb's High Feast, number 407.
Thank you.
Bring your brothers and sisters in my sacrifice and yours. May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. For the praise of the Lord in his name. For our good and for all his holy church.
Grant your church, O Lord, we pray the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are conceived in mystery, in the offerings we here present through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For at the supper with his apostles, establishing for ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faith by the sacred mystery, you make him holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by the right teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. For those who are unable to be with us today, who are unable to receive the Eucharist at this time, will now pray a prayer of spiritual communion. Lord Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament, and I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Thank you. Let's pray.
Grant, Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in that shared and unified life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking to ruin souls.
Recessional hymn is number 572, Blessed by Your Sacrifice, number 572.